As the clock ticks down to the much-awaited Non-Aligned Movement and G77 Summit, Uganda's permanent representative to the UN, Ambassador Adonia Ayebare, has made a passionate appeal to the security operatives to make it smooth for Ugandans to go around their local businesses during these summits. Giving an example of diplomatic cities like New York, Ayebare noted that common people don't have to be inconvenienced during such big events.
Really called upon those responsible, the security services, civil aviation authority at the airport, to really make it convenient for the local people to go around their business and to really designate routes where the guests will use, but business should continue. I've lived in these diplomatic capital cities like Addis Ababa, now New York. When we have the General Assembly in New York, New Yorkers don't like September. Everybody goes for vacation because of closures. Where there are VIPs, because of security, that's unavoidable. But in this case, we really make sure that life is really smooth for a normal Ugandan to go with their duties.
Ayebare's concern has come in at a time when Kampala Capital City Authority already embarked on massive operations, cracking a whip on all the illegal vendors in the city and nearby suburbs with the intention of making the city light as guests come in. Ayebare reiterated that Uganda will reap big from hosting these momentous gatherings.
Percent of the countries in the world will be represented here. So that's huge, and it's expensive. And what will Uganda gain? Uganda will gain a lot. First of all, you are going to have almost 1,500 people in town. They will do a lot of things. They will eat, they will drink. Some might decide to stay and, you know, be tourists. And the tourist is defined as somebody who stays in a country more than 3 days and spends money. And all of them will spend here more than 3 days and they will spend money. So they qualify as tourists, even if they don't go anywhere out of Kampala. So it's huge. Uganda will benefit from that.
Even when these summits conclude, Uganda will still be in charge of chairing the Non-Aligned Movement Summit for the coming 3 years and G77 summits for the next 1 year.
Uganda is chairing NAM and G77. We automatically have a good relationship with these countries. We can leverage. The point is, do we have a strategy to leverage this so that our country can benefit? Yes, we are working on it. By the virtue of being chair, we will have these contacts. We can have investment, we can have technology transfer, we can have many, many things. Innovation. These countries are really, really advanced in terms of technology.
Ambassador Ayebare has also highlighted on how the summits will help developing countries to gain bargaining power on the international scene.
There is that countries like Uganda, developing countries, have to work in a group like NAM and G77 in order to have leverage and bargaining power on the international scene. So that is valid now with the geopolitics. You can imagine if Uganda was negotiating with the European Union alone, we will not do it. We don't have that influence and power. But when we go as G77, we have influence and power, or NAM. So these organizations actually are more relevant now. And NAM is not the NAM of the 60s. These countries are really, like I said, really rich countries that can really help each other.
Describing Uganda as a friendliest country, Ayebare is optimistic that the visitors will have a lasting impression. The NAM and G77 plus China summits kick off next week on Monday. These are the second largest high-level events to be hosted by Uganda after Chogham in 2007. Report compiled by Jaliat Namuwaya for the news.